Hey guys, welcome to our testing timer for the SAT subject tests. If you're taking the SAT subject tests, you can use this testing timer to realistically recreate the testing room. Note that I'm going to abbreviate the script for these tests because the actual script is almost 20 minutes long, and that's really, really long, and I don't think you need to sit through all of that just now today. But I will say my biggest tip for you guys when you fill out the bubble sheet before you get started, make sure you put the appropriate number that corresponds to the exact subject test area that you're taking on your bubble sheet. Approximately 1 in 200 or so students mess up their notation of which subject test they took, and that can delay your score or actually cause your scores to be canceled. So make sure you don't screw that one up. But otherwise, let's get started with our script and get your practice tests ready to go. Finally, be sure to subscribe to our YouTube channel before we get started and to our mailing list at supertutortv.com/subscribe to get more tips for all of your test prep and college admissions questions. Good morning. As you know, you're here to take the SAT subject tests. Congratulations on taking this important step toward your college and career goals. Before you begin the test, I'm going to read some instructions. Please listen carefully and raise your hand if you have any questions. Remember, my role is to make sure you have the best opportunity to demonstrate your skills and knowledge. First, let's make sure you're in the right room. If any of the information on your admission ticket doesn't match what's posted, or if you have the word roster or NAR in the header of your ticket, please raise your hand now. Please note, during the November administration, you may be doing a language with listening test, and then you're going to have further instructions because you will have some sort of CD player. And if you don't have a CD player, you're supposed to raise your hand, but that doesn't apply to most of you, so I'm just going to keep going. College Board SAT policies are designed to make sure all students have a fair and equal test experience. That means there are certain testing rules and consequences that your proctor is going to get into, but I'm going to skip over those and just tell you, don't use your phone. I know you're just taking a practice test, but turn off your devices and prepare your desk for testing. If you brought a backup calculator, extra batteries, drinks, or snacks, put them on the floor under your desk. On your desk, you should have an admission ticket, number 2 pencils with erasers, an acceptable calculator if you brought one for taking a mathematics test, and an acceptable CD player if you're taking a language with listening test today. Please remove everything else from your desk and close your bags now. I am now going to give an answer sheet and test book to each of you. Check to see that both are for the SAT subject tests. Do not open them. If your answer sheet doesn't say SAT subject tests, raise your hand. Then your proctor is going to tell you to fill out your personal information on your answer sheet, which I'm not going to do right now. But what I am going to say is that you may pick from any subject test in your test book to take today, regardless of what test you registered for. You can also decide to add tests if you registered for only 1 or 2 tests. If you add tests, you will be billed later for additional test fees. On the front of your test booklet, find the page number for the first test you were taking. Open your book to that page and read the instruction at the top. Now turn to page 2 of your answer sheet with test 1 displayed on it. Refer to the front and back of your test book to copy the numbers from the boxes numbered 7, 8, and 9 exactly as shown onto fields 7, 8, and 9 on your answer sheet page. Next, fill in the bubble of the test you are about to take. It is critical that you provide the right test name for your test to be scored. If you are taking a mathematics test, be sure to fill in the bubble for the correct level, 1 or 2. If you're taking a language test, be careful not to fill in the bubble for the listening version. If you're taking the biology test, fill in the bubble for the emphasis you choose, either ecological or molecular. This is probably the most important part of the introduction to your standardized test here, because just under 0.5% of students every time who take the SAT subject tests fail to properly indicate which subject test they take, and that can delay your scores or even cause your scores to be canceled. So please ensure that you don't screw that up. Each section of your answer sheet has 100 numbered spaces. All SAT subject tests, however, contain fewer than 100 questions. Keep your answer sheet and test book flat on your desk during the test. If you find a defect with either, or if you realize you've been writing answers in the wrong section of your answer sheet, raise your hand at that time. If you have any final questions, you may ask them now. Once we begin, you'll have 1 hour to work on the first subject test. You will be given your entire amount of testing time for this test. If you finish before time is called, you may check your work on this test, but you may not move on to another SAT subject test. Remain in your seat and do not talk. Are there any questions? Once again, find the page number of the first test you are taking and open your test book to that page. Make sure you are on the answer sheet page marked Test 1. Now turn to the page in your test book, read the directions, and begin work. Good luck, everyone. Time starts now. You have 40 minutes remaining in this test. You have 20 minutes remaining in this test. You have 5 minutes remaining in this test. Stop work and put your pencil down. Close your test book and keep it closed on your desk. If you took the biology test, please make sure you have the correct bubble filled in for the test you took. If you are taking another test, put your answer sheet inside the front of your test book and keep the test book closed on your desk. If you're registered for only one test, you can still decide to stay to take additional tests now. If you are not taking another test, place your admission ticket on your desk in plain sight. Then raise your hand and I will collect your test materials. If you are finished testing for today, please listen to this important information. You may cancel your scores for any reason. If you wish to cancel your scores, ask me for a request to cancel test scores form. We will now have a 5-minute break. If you brought a snack, you may eat it in designated areas only. Do not go anywhere other than designated areas, the hallway, or the restroom. Do not talk in the hallways or discuss test questions with anyone. If you leave the room, take your ID and admission ticket with you. We start testing again in exactly 5 minutes. While we're on break, if you like this testing timer, be sure to give it a thumbs up. You can also subscribe to our YouTube channel by clicking subscribe or to our mailing list at supertutortv.com/subscribe. Want more tips on SAT subject tests? Be sure to check out the videos on our channel. And if you're looking for help on the SAT or the ACT, check out our online courses at supertutortv.com. Please take your seat. Filling in test 2 information. On the front of your test book, find the page number for the second test you are taking. Open your book to that page and read the instructions at the top. Now turn to page 3 of your answer sheet with test 2 displayed on it. Refer to the front and back of your test book to copy the numbers from boxes numbered 7, 8, and 9 exactly as shown onto fields 7, 8, and 9 on your answer sheet page. Next, fill in the bubble of the test you're about to take. If you are taking the biology test, when you reach question 60, carefully follow the directions in your test book. If you are taking biology E, continue filling in your answers in bubbles 61 to 80. If you are taking biology M, skip these questions and turn to the questions beginning with 81 and mark your answers in bubbles 81 to 100. Be sure to answer the questions that match the test bubble you filled in at the top of the answer sheet page. If you're taking the chemistry test now, please raise your hand. Be sure you have read the instructions in the test booklet for answering some of the questions that have a different format. If you are taking a subject test in mathematics now, get your calculator out and place it on your desk. If you are not taking a math test now, put your calculator on the floor under your desk. When using a calculator, follow these guidelines. Keep it flat on your desk or hold it so other students cannot view your work. If your calculator malfunctions and you have batteries or a backup, raise your hand. I will see if your substitute is acceptable. If you do not have a backup, you may continue the test or you may cancel your score on just the mathematics test. If you decide to continue testing, I cannot give you any extra time to make up the time lost. Each section of your answer sheet has 100 numbered spaces. All SAT subject tests, however, contain fewer than 100 questions. Keep your answer sheet and test book flat on your desk during the test. If you find a defect with either or you realize there's been writing answers in the wrong section of your answer sheet, raise your hand at that time. If you finish before time is called, you may check your work on this test, but you may not move on or back to a different SAT subject test. Keep your answer sheet and test book flat on your desk. Are there any questions? Once we begin, you'll have 1 hour to work on the second subject test. Find the page number of your second SAT subject test and open your test book to that page. Make sure you are on the answer sheet marked test 2. Now turn to that page, read the directions, and begin work. Good luck, everyone. Time starts now. You have 40 minutes remaining in this test. You have 20 minutes remaining in this test. You have 5 minutes remaining in this test. Stop work and put your pencil down. Close your test book and keep it on your desk. If you took a biology test, please make sure you have the correct bubble filled in for the test you took. Now close your answer sheet. If you have registered for fewer than 3 tests, you can still decide to take another additional test now. If you are finished for the day, place your admission ticket on your desk in plain sight, then raise your hand and I will collect your test materials. We will now take a 5-minute break. If you have brought a snack, you may eat it in designated areas only. Do not go anywhere other than the designated areas, the hallway or the restroom. Do not talk in the hallway or discuss test questions with anyone. If you leave the room, take your ID and admission ticket with you. We start testing again in exactly 5 minutes. During this break, head over to supertutortv.com/subscribe and subscribe to our mailing list. We'll keep you posted of any awesome deals we have on our online SAT or ACT courses, or any news we think could be useful for you as you prepare for all of your standardized tests and college applications. Want more tips on SAT subject tests? Be sure to check out the videos on our channel. And if you're looking for help on the SAT or the ACT, check out our online courses at supertutortv.com. Are you enjoying this testing timer? If so, please give it a thumbs up. Please take your seat. On the front of your test book, find the page number for the third test you are taking. Open your book to that page, read the instructions at the top. Now turn to page 4 of your answer sheet with test 3 displayed on it. Refer to the front and back of your test book to copy the numbers from the boxes numbered 7, 8, and 9, exactly as shown onto the fields 7, 8, and 9 on your answer sheet page. If you are taking a biology test, when you reach question 60, carefully follow the directions in your test book. If you are taking biology E, continue filling in your answers in bubbles 61 to 80. If you are taking biology M, skip these questions and turn to the questions beginning with 81 and mark your answers in bubbles 81 to 100. Be sure to answer the questions that match the test bubble you filled in at the top of the answer sheet page. If you are taking a subject test in mathematics test right now, get your calculator out and place it on your desk. If you are not taking a math test now, put your calculator on the floor under your desk. Once we begin, you will have 1 hour to work on the third subject test. Again, find the page number of your third SAT subject test. Open your test booklet to that page. Make sure you are on the answer sheet page marked test 3. Now turn the page in your test book, read the directions, and begin work. Good luck, everyone. Time starts now. You have 40 minutes remaining in this test. You have 20 minutes remaining in this test. You have 5 minutes remaining in this test. stop work and put your pencil down. Close your test book and keep it closed on your desk. If you took a biology test, please make sure you have the correct bubble filled in for the test you took. Now close your answer sheet and place it on top of your test book. Also, place your admission ticket on your desk in plain sight. I will now collect an answer sheet and a test book from each of you. Please remain quietly in your seat till I am finished. The test administration is now over. Congratulations on your hard work. Thanks for watching our testing timer, guys, and be sure to check out all our tips for the SAT and the ACT right here on SupertutorTV.com. Thanks for watching.